is Maria Keller and I'm a digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to create an animation and then mask it into a world in Adobe After Effects. So first we're gonna open After Effects. You can see that I have it right here. And once you do that, you can go here to Project, and if you don't see it, you can go to Window and then go to Project or use the shortcut Ctrl-0. Now that you have that one, all you have to do is click on this little project icon right there. You can pick any name you want. In my case, I'm gonna type animation. And then the width and the height are going to be 800 by 600. Have a frame rate of 30 and a duration for now of 120. And as the background color, I'm gonna click on that one. Probably by default, you're gonna have it black, but we're gonna change it to white. So just move it right there, press okay, and you're gonna see it's white right there, and click okay. Now that you have created your comp, we're gonna begin working on it. So first thing is I'm gonna go to my type tool right there on the top and type my word. It's going to be ocean. I'm gonna move it with my move tool right there. And now that I have it right there, what I can do is go window align. And this window is going to appear. In here I can make sure that I'm aligning to my composition and make sure that I align horizontal and vertical. Now that my word is in the center, I'm going to go window, character, or use the shortcut Ctrl-6. And here on the character, I can change the type of my font. So if you go to Google Fonts, which is a very awesome place to get free fonts, you can find this Conforta font and just download it. And once you do that, you can type in here Conforta. It's going to be bold, and right there on the bottom you can change the size. For now 150 is fine for me, so I'm going to leave it right there. I'm going to zoom in by pressing Ctrl plus, and then I'm going to go to my rectangle tool right there on the top, or use the shortcut Q. Now let's just draw a rectangle. That is like that. And remember that you can still scale it, so I'm just making it a little bit bigger so it covers the whole composition. And actually something like this. Now here you can change the fill. I'm gonna go to my fill and sample a color that I had already selected. You can see it right there on the bottom. And I'm gonna select my shape layer. Then press Ctrl-C. And then Ctrl-B to create a copy, and simply I'm going to move that copy a little bit down. I'm going to go to my fill and sample a color that I had already selected, so just that number that you can see there. And I'm going to do the same. Ctrl-C and Ctrl-B to make a copy of that shape layer 3, and Ctrl-C and Ctrl-B to make another copy. So I'm going to go to my shape layer 3 and move it a little bit to the bottom. Then go to my shape layer 4 and move it right there on the bottom. And I'm going to sample the colors again by using my eyedropper, changing the fill color. Press OK. Do the same to shape layer 4 and press OK. Now I want to make sure that they have the same space between them, so I can select all of them. Go to my align window, so go window align. And then instead of aligning layers to selection, I can do that and distribute my layers horizontally. So now they have an even space. Now I'm going to go right click and pre-compose. And when you do that, a window like this is going to appear. In here you could input your new composition name. So I'm just going to call it Waves and press OK. Now that I have this, I can go and select my ocean type layer that I have right there and just put it on the top. So just move it right there on the top. Now I'm going to go to my waves, and here you can see this mode, or you, if you toggle the switches, you can see the others. So just go there and go alpha track matte. Now you can see that it's getting masked. Now if I press my spacebar to preview my animation, you can see that nothing is happening. So I'm going to go to my effects and presets, and I can go window effects and presets. And I'm going to type in here wave. I'm going to find this effect under this sort that is called wave wrap and just apply it to my waves. And if I do that and I preview a little my animation, you can see how that is happening. And here I can control the different height and width that they have. So just so you can see it, I'm going to have no track mat for now, so you can see how the waves are right there. And you could change the wave type to and play with these options. For now, we're going to leave it in sine. Change the wave height to 13. Change the width to 150. So we get some waves like this. The direction is 90 and the wave speed 1. Now we can play with the face if we think something is not happening. Now you can see right there that I have some quality issues. You could change the anti-aliasing to be at his highest or probably medium. You're not going to see a lot of difference. So I'm going to go medium. Again, go to my track mat to make it alpha. And now I can preview my animation. Now, other thing that I can do is go to my waves, press P to activate the position, go here and on the first keyframe and set a key, then go to my frame theory and set another key. And what I'm going to do is select my position on the first frame and take it all the way down. So now if I preview that, you can see how they are getting filled. Now if I go to my frame 90 and set another key right there, and then I go all the way to the end to my frame 119, I can select this first frame, this first keyframe, copy, and then just press Ctrl P to paste it on the end. So now I can preview my animation. You're gonna see how this gets filled, and then the waves go out. Now if we let it run on real time, you're gonna see how it gets filled and how it goes out. With this, you have your animation completed. All you need to do is just press Ctrl M to add it to the render queue and export it in whatever format works for you. And for example, here QuickTime, and select a format option, animation, or any other codec that you need, and just press OK. Or you could also use the Adobe Media Encoder. So to do that, just go File, Export, and add to Adobe Media Encoder. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.